Hi, and welcome to another Godot VR tutorial video. Today, we're going to look at a climbing mechanic. I've created this example project, and we'll just look at how it's put together. The GitHub project is in the description below. Let me know in the comments if you prefer this style of video. The mechanic is pretty straightforward. The player can grab the handholds and pull themselves upwards. The scene in Godot consists of a small section of a rock face. It's only about 60 meters high and maybe 100 meters wide. Most of the rock face is created with a single asset that is used multiple times and simply rotated to create variations. Standing on the rock face obscures enough of the surroundings that the player has no idea there isn't a whole mountain there. This is a very simple scene that can be dressed up a lot further. But it does show how you can obtain a really nice effect with very little assets. We have a player subscene here. We'll have a closer look at that in a minute. We'll start with the handholds scattered along our path up the mountain. We have a single scene for a handhold that is just used a number of times. Looking at this scene, we see that it is a very simple scene. I've just used two bars to make the handhold. You can replace it with a nicer mesh or create variations. At the root, we have a static body. This allows us to interact with the handhold. I've put the static body into layer 2 to make detection easier. We also need a collision shape for our static body, and this is just a box that contains the handhold. We also have two spatial nodes that allow us to anchor our hands to when we grab the handhold. There are separate ones for each hand, as their orientation is slightly different. Just to demonstrate this, I'll load in my hand mesh scene, and we can see the hand anchored to one of these spatial points. Looking at the script for the scene, all we find here is a helper method that returns the global transform of the anchor for a given hand. Looking at our player, we find our standard ARVR origin node at the root. I'm using the OpenXR plugin here and have assigned its first-person controller script to my root node. The rest of the scene is set up with different subscenes for the hands, hence I'm not using the first-person controller scene from the plugin. We have a configuration node that provides easy access to the configuration of the OpenXR plugin. We also have an ARVR camera node. Note that I have unticked layer 10 and added a mesh as a child that has been placed in this layer. This results in our head casting a shadow without the head actually being visible to the player. For now, the head is just a capsule shape. Next are our left and right hand scenes. We reuse the same scenes as we want the same logic to enable grabbing handholds with either hand. At the root of our hand scene is an ARVR controller node. Next is a spatial node on which we anchor our hand mesh. This is a node we'll be moving to adjust the position of the hand mesh when we grab a handhold. Note that this node is moved into place so our hand mesh is in a natural position as our controller node is not centered on the hand. Finally, we have a subscene that is our hand detector node. At the root here is an area node that is set to detect any object within the area that are in layer 2, so it will only detect our handholds. Looking at the script on our hand controller, we'll find all the logic that allows us to grab the handholds. At the top, we've got a variable that keeps track of which handhold is nearest to us. We have a variable that indicates whether we are holding onto that handhold, and we have a variable in which we store our original transform for our anchor. As we'll be moving this, we need to remember this location. Next, we have a helper method that returns our isHolding variable. We'll need this later on. Then when our script is ready, and when our detector area detects handholds entering or leaving our area, we call a function that will determine our closest handhold. We can see here how our signals are set up. We obtain an array with handhelds that are in our area. If this area is empty, we clear our variable. If we do have entries in our area, we loop through this to find out which one is closest to us. Looking at our process code, we default our isHolding to false, and then check if we have a nearest handhold. If not, we simply reset the transform to our original value, and we assign our grab property on our hand machine based on our grip value. On controllers that support it, our grip value represents how much we are squeezing our controller. The property on our hand machine changes whether our hand is open or closed. If we do have a handhold we're closest to, we first obtain the transform for the correct anchor point from our handheld scene. We want this transform in the local space of our controller node. To do this, we multiply the inverse of our controller's global transform with the anchor's transform. This means that both our handheld anchor and our source anchor are in the same locality, making it easy to work with them. Now we check if our grip button is pressed. If this is true, we place our hand anchor using the transform we calculated from the handhold's anchor. This places our hand on that handhold, even if the physical location of our hand isn't exactly at this position. We also set our grab property to 1, closing our hand so it looks like we're grabbing the handhold. Finally, we set our isHolding variable to true. If our grip button is not pressed, we are going to move our hand between our controller's position and the position of the handhold, based on the distance our controller is to our handhold. This gives the effect our handhold acts like a magnet to our hand. We simply calculate this distance, divided by the radius of our detector to get a value between 0 and 1, and then interpolate between our handhold anchor transform and our original transform. We also assign our grab property based on our grab input on our controller. All the code so far allows us to grab the handholds we have placed around our scene, but it doesn't yet move our player when the player moves their hands while holding a handhold. This logic is controlled by a script placed on a helper node called movement control. As we want this logic to be performed after the logic on each hand, we want this further down in our node tree. In our script, we set up a few export variables so we know which nodes represent our hands and which node is our origin node. Next, we keep track of which hands are currently holding handholds and what their last position was. We also have a variable that tracks how fast we're falling when we're not holding any handholds. In our process function, we're going to check each hand. First, we obtain the isHolding value from the script on our hand, and then we compare it to the previous value. If it has changed, we simply assign the new value. When we've just grabbed the handhold, we don't know yet how much we've moved since grabbing it, so we skip that bit. If the value didn't change, and we are holding our handhold, we calculate our delta movement and add it to our delta variable and increase our count. We do the same for our right hand as we did for our left hand. Now we check if our handholding count is bigger than 0. If so, we start by dividing our delta movement by the number of hands that is holding a handhold. If only one hand is holding a handhold, this count will be 1, and our delta will be just the movement of that hand. If both hands are holding a handhold, our count will be 2, and our delta ends up being the average of the movement of both hands. Now we simply subtract this delta movement from the global position of our origin node. This moves the player in the opposite direction of our hand movement. To keep our hands locked on our handholds, we need to move the hand anchors for any hand holding a handhold by adding our delta. We also reset our fall velocity here. If we're not holding any handholds, we're going to apply our fall logic. Here we simply increase our fall velocity by our gravity, and then apply our velocity to our Y position. If our Y becomes 0, we hit the ground and stop falling. I'm not detecting here if our player has fallen to their death. Finally, for each hand that is holding a handhold, we store their current position so we can use them to calculate our delta's next frame. And that is the whole solution to implement a climbing mechanic in VR. Thank you for watching, and especially a thank you to all my patrons and YouTube members who have stuck by me this year. If you want to support my work, please consider becoming a patron or a member. You can follow me on Twitter for more regular updates of what I'm working on. Please leave a like on the video if you enjoyed the content and let me know in the comments whether you enjoyed this format. Until next time.